A fishy design by using textured paint and watercolor. Can't you see that it's just raining? Now it may seem like I am just going straight from a free draw, but I'm not. I have placed a pencil drawing of a fish that I've done, and then I'm tracing my pencil lines with permanent marker. Now for this project, you can choose whether you want to do the same exact fish or you can attempt to do another fish, but we're not going to spend a ton of time on this project, so be careful with it, with that decision. If you want to go ahead and practice drawing the fish on practice paper, then you may do that. If you want to try to go straight at it with the watercolor paper, then you may. But remember, draw lightly so that you can erase your mistakes, and therefore you don't have to waste any paper, especially the watercolor paper. Now you can see that I'm trying to capture some of the features of the fish. So for example, big mouth, the scales. Fin on the side, the dorsal fin, the top fin, bottom fin, the back fin. And my fish is a cartoon type of fish. You're gonna see in a second a big eye on it. And I prefer with this project, I prefer it to be more of a cartoon design. There you go. There's the fish. Next, we're going to be focusing on the texture. So if you want to start off the project by drawing your fish and getting the permanent marker down on the fish, then that would be good. The next part to go at would be the texture part. Now, texture is the feel and appearance or consistency of a surface. And that is what we're going to have within our background. We're going to start off with placing blue acrylic paint on the paper, brushing it on, and we need to work pretty quickly because we do not want the paint to harden before we place the texture inside. Once you're done placing paint all over the paper, then you're going to go back over your wet paint with a fork. And you need to go in a wavy line across from side to side of your paper horizontally, so that it's consistent, the texture is consistent, and creates a pattern feel for the viewer. Now you don't have to rub hard, you don't want to make a hole or scratch up your paper too much, but you have to put a little bit of pressure. And there you go, there's the texture. It really pops out and gives a three-dimensional feel on that paint. Now while you're waiting for that paint to dry, now you're gonna cut your fish out. Now you can see that I'm following certain lines. I'm following the scales, trying to show you how and where I'm going to cut this fish out. I'm going to cut it in certain sections. And the reason why I'm going to do this is because when we glue it down to the blue background, we're gonna leave little sections between each section of the fish, so that you can see the background through the fish. Again, it gives a three-dimensional feel to your design. Now, of course, I've got this sped up. I'm not cutting it out this quickly. And that's just so that we can get through the video at a decent time. So you need to be very, very careful and make sure that you're cutting neatly. Want to put craftsmanship into our design. And you can see as I have laid it down on the paper there, you can see the sections between each scale. Now with watercolor, we need to be careful with how much paint versus how much water we use. We don't want to use a ton of water. If we use too much water, then we're not going to have a lot of control where we want the paint to go. If you use too much water, then, for example, my paint might end up in my lips of the fish, and I don't want my fish to have blue lips. I want my lips to be red, so I gotta be careful. Also, you can see how the bottom of the fish is a little lighter than the top of the fish, and you can see now that I'm blending it and giving it a gradual value change. Again, value is the lightness or darkness of a color. So we don't want colors to go straight from dark to light on this project. We want it to give a gradual feel to it, which again helps with the three-dimensional look. Now you can see I've placed a little more blue there. Again, I'm going to go over it to give a gradual value change to that color. Now, my choice was to do the head blue and the lips red and the fins, all the fins green, and to do each scale a different color. You know, it's up to you on what you want to do. You're free to do what you want to do. You can have your fish green, you can have the scales all one color and have a consistent color. Or you can do something like I did, which I did more of like a rainbow fish. All the people in the street walking fast as the feet can take them, I just roll through town. Again, I'm trying to be very careful on how much water I'm using versus how much paint I'm using. I don't want to use too much paint because then it becomes very, very dark. But then again, I need to use enough paint to where you can tell what color it is. This engine screams out loud, centipede gonna crawl westbound, so I don't even make a sound, cause it's gonna sting me when I leave this town, and all the people in the street that'll never get to meet. One thing that you're gonna have to think about is if you have, you know, if you cut out your fish and you don't have time to paint it, and then you don't have time to glue it all in one class, you know, how are you going to make sure that you get every piece back the next class? So make sure that you're writing your name very small on each piece so that when you come in for next class, you know, you can find your pieces and make sure that you have your pieces and not someone else's. And you can see right there how I'm putting spaces between each scale. That's very, very important to do because that's what gives and helps that three-dimensional feel. So this is not an option. This is something that I'm asking you to do with your fish design. And the textures appear right in between each scale. We have our fish. Now at this point in time, you would take each piece and glue it down nice and neat. Be careful with that glue. Don't use too much glue because it'll be a mess. Again, craftsmanship. It's a make or break. And that's the finished product.